Hello, my C-Lovelies. How are you beautiful people doing today? You doing great? I hope you're doing great. I don't want you to be doing good. I want you to be doing great. Because I certainly am. I am done with finals. Ooh, it feels so good to be able to be back here on our beautiful world. I've just been itching for it this whole week. You know, I made this last episode working on this, and I'm like, I just want to complete this thing. I have so many good plans for this. I want to get it done. And also, I hit 400 subscribers. Yay! Thank you, guys. You might be wondering, where's your epic special, C-Luv? Well, I just finished finals, so I haven't had any time to work on it. And honestly, I don't know if I will do one. I might do like a short thank you, but nothing out of the ordinary. You know, we did the prank wars and everything else, and then the funny commercial last time. But I just gave y'all three specials for that Skyblock trilogy. So, yeah, I'm kind of just wanting to do some normal episodes right now. And I'm just so excited. There's just so much I want to do that's not related to a special, I guess. And the specials, they take up a lot of time. Like, the time it takes me to do one special, I could have dished out 3 to 4 more episodes. And they're special, you know? They don't come out all the time. But yeah, otherwise it wouldn't be a special. But let's get into today's episode, guys. Just wanted to give you all that little spiel first. Feel free to comment below your thoughts on it, and we'll see if I'll end up making one or not. So what I would like to do, I'm letting all the, this is our first ever harvest, by the way, so I'm assuming it's going to take a while to get down there to move all the items, but that's okay, because whenever all of them are full, you know, I'll just run around, hit the lever, give it a minute or two, and then we'll go down there and do all the good stuff. But let's talk about the farm for a second here. What I would like to do is maybe have a piston elevator coming up through here, and if not, somewhere around here. Number two, I would like to have an automatic wheat, potato, carrot farm station where you can kind of AFK and just maybe leave something on the right controller, and if I have a ton of bone meal, and I can just sit there and it will do stuff. It's a small little building. You know what I'm talking about. At least I hope you do. I don't know if I explained it well, but I want to put one either here or there, just a little station. And then I want to have a storage location. This is step number three, somewhere up here to our farms. And what I would like to do, since we're going to be getting so much quantity of everything, I would like to have maybe some storage mine carts go all towards a location from the farms and drop off everything. I think that would be cool to have all of it up here, so we have all the materials whenever I need something to all be up here instead of having to go down underneath. So, well, let's talk about some of the stuff that I've made progress on now. I've dug out everything. They're all down to level 9. Do I have a map on me? I don't have a map on me. I don't know what layer we're on. Let's see. In here. Yeah, these chests are getting really full now. Oh, wait, is it? Yep, here it is. I died. I was lucky and was able to get all my stuff saved. Alright, so we're at 64. What happened was, I was digging down on this one, and like right now I'm not even wearing a headset. Sometimes I don't just wear a headset. Like normally I'll be listening to a podcast or something, and I didn't hear lava. And, you know, you just get going in a mode. I mean, this is a lot of digging. And I fell in lava, but luckily I was able to dig myself out quick enough and run to the other side of the room. So if the lava was here, I ran to that corner and I died and none of my stuff fell in lava. So I was pretty stoked about that. You know, no big whoop for me. I just spawned up top, ran back down, picked up my stuff and continued. So, okay. Now, if you haven't noticed, we have this windy staircase. This is gross. I don't like this. And let's see how much stuff we have on us. So we got 5 wheat, a stack of seeds, and that. Okay, let's see how much we got from that first little bit. That was only 3 layers worth. So stack and a half, and about 2.5 stacks of seeds. Oh, and there might be some stuff over here. Yep. Over here, I've kind of, just a few things. That's the one area. And then over here we have our other farm, you know, where it comes down. So we have, this is the middle point. The fountain is directly above us right here. So we have all of this area to kind of try to tie everything together. And I'm assuming that this episode might take us a little bit longer. Or like it might be broken up into two episodes. And I know when you do back-to-back episodes of something, it can, like on the same project, it will annoy people and they won't be as interested. Like the City Hall thing never got any views, and I tried to break that up as much as I could. And that's why I haven't done the interior still of it yet. But with this, I feel like y'all gave me a really good likes on the last episode, so I figured y'all wouldn't mind me to continue working on this. And it might take two episodes, but if y'all are getting bored and you want me to switch it up, just comment down below and maybe I'll work on another project and then come back in a few episodes and finish everything, because I have a feeling this is going to take at least two episodes. But let's take a look over here real quick. Let me shut off this water. Okay, now these stairs are gross. We don't like this. I'm thinking about changing everything up and having ladders that go down. And this is where I was thinking about putting some of the ladder locations. I don't know if I like these trap doors, though. I don't know. But let's go ahead and jump on down and see what we can work with. And this is what I'm going to work on right now, because I'm about to do a cutaway. I'm trying to get inspired for this. I'm thinking this could be every floor. They would kind of look like this. I'm thinking about putting this stuff over here. I don't know if I like it too high, so what I like to do is put trap doors all along it. Do I have trap doors on me? I do. That's not what I want. You're what I want, thank you. So we can just go like this, and yeah, we could have something like that. Now it won't be grass, and what I'm thinking about doing is just putting whatever the farm is. So if this is could be carrot, then that will be carrot all the way across. So yeah, I'm trying to get creative, and then for each level I'll probably just duplicate it and see what we can do. So I'm gonna do a cutaway now, and let's see what ideas I can come up with for decorating for each little floor. Because by the way, if the trapdoors are here, the water won't go down, so that's why it's raised up. I would like it to be right here, but we'll see. Give me a little bit and we'll see what I can come up with. Alrighty guys, I'm getting excited for it. I'm pumped up, I'm ready, I'm feeling good. Alright, let's do a little game first though before I show you what I've been working on. So, we're just having a conversation, just you and me, alright? What color do you think of when I say blooming, nutrition, growth? What color pops into your mind? Growth, nutrition, blooming, like blossom. What color? Okay. You have your color? Good. To me, it's this color right here. Green. Green. You know, you have the plants. You know, we have to eat gross broccoli and other types of things. And beautiful plants are green. So, since this is a farm, I decided to try to utilize that a little bit. And let's go down here. I'm really excited for this. And so green is the main color, as you can see down here. Now, I know not everything here is going together right now, but I've been working on just some random stuff. Now, let's take a look over here. These three, we have the jack-o'-lanterns facing compared to if they're on the side. They both give off the great light. So I'm liking this side more. Over here we have carrots, potatoes, and wheat. So we will know what it will kind of look like if we decide to use a full row of one of these three. So, you know, right over here it's really tough to see behind. And, you know, we got that one gap of water, so it gives just a little bit of blue. And of course, we have our little iron golem farm that gives us so many roses. Might as well throw some of those down. The beautiful grass. And look at the luscious leaves. Love it. Let's look over here real quick. I'll let y'all get y'all's thoughts over here. So we have the stone bricks. They go all the way up. Now over here, it just stops right here. And then the I have spruce wood there and spruce wood right there. So that's something else I'm trying to figure out, is this little design. And I couldn't really figure out what to put back there, so I threw leaves. Why not? let's keep the green focal points. And I got jack-o'-lanterns right in both little corners, so it gives off a nice little bright look over there as well. Now let's take a look at this. Now, glowstone. Man, I have to put so much glowstone down in all of these areas, and I decided to put trapdoors on them. And I don't know. I don't know which one I like more, to be honest. They're both pretty cool. I think I'm leaning towards jack-o'-lanterns. They're going to be cheaper. They're more of a pain to put down, because you have to have a block underneath it to place it. So, all right, now let's go over here. This is a completely other design that we could use, or maybe we could have two different designs on both sides. Over here, I put vines down. Why? I don't know why. I would need a lot more vines. I need to make a tall wall and just start growing them so I could get them and shearing them. But just another little thought, over here we have stone brick compared to the spruce wood. So, I'm kind of looking. Part of me is just leaning towards the spruce wood. You know, we got a lot of green and then we have a lot of brown. So, yeah. Now let's look over here at the last little piece. I didn't know what to put here. When originally I had spruce wood, I was like, man, that is just so plain. And lately, I've just been throwing C's. Oh, no. I didn't mean to do that. Man, I just barely touched it. So, I decided to just put a little C there, and I put dirt around it. And yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. And now it's kind of interesting to try to get this. As you know, we have to have water. And so, let's see if we can just go back here real quick so I can show you where I put the water. Yep, right there. No. Block. Aww. Dang it. Get me back up. Yeah, that's what I thought. Give me that. Dang it. Well, at least I didn't get all of it. There we go. So I had to put the water in some pretty interesting spots to get that to work. And if you're also wondering where I put the water so the wheat will grow, it takes 4 to grow. So this right here, you can see the water right there. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, reaches. This is middle point, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then also I have another one right there. So that's what I got going on up here. And I don't think I'm going to work any more on this for today. We might go try to do something else now. But I wanted you guys to get a look at this and give me some of your feedback on all this. I showed you everything that we're going to be working with in here. And we're going to have to be duplicating this 11 times in each farm, so 33. So it takes up a lot of space. Like, it's going to take a while to get everything looking nice on each level. But, I mean, I could also vary it maybe from level to level. But, man, that would take a lot of time. So let me know your thoughts on all this, guys. And then I don't know how I feel about the sea here. I just don't know what to put up, so I'm just like, hey, I'll just put in a random C for C-Luv. I wish I could make an easy C with a heart, like a logo that I could build. That would be cool. And there you go. And I don't think I showed this off in the last episode, but I do have C's on the back of these buildings. Because, again, it just looks so flat. And I just felt like it needed something detail-wise, so... I don't know what I'm going to do next, so you're going to find out in 3 seconds from now. See you in a bit. Another iron golem. Getting destroyed. Thank you for the iron, Mr. Iron Golem Man. Well, I just got back from the nether. I mean, not the nether, the end. Got me a whole bunch more ender pearls. Whenever I go, I try to empty as much stuff, and I bring as many ender pearls back over to the mountainside. And I know I haven't done any building on camera this episode, and I don't think I'm going to, because this is the next day now, and I've been working on some awesome stuff. You ready to see it? Where is it? It's right here. I built it. Can you see it? Can you tell what it is? Where is it? What the? Yeah. I'm excited for this. Now, if it sits... I have a block switcher, hidden staircase, flush with the ground. The problem is, if I leave it on there too long, the grass will disappear. But that's okay, because I can get grass back on there and remember it for the future. But check it out. Yeah, I'm pretty happy about this. I started trying to work with it by myself. And I spent a few hours trying to redstone and figure it all out. And I was like, okay, how can I do this? A little hidden staircase. And I kept working and I kept working and I gave up. And then I looked up a YouTube video. If I remember, I'll put it in the description. And it still didn't work the way I wanted it to. So I ended up learning what a T flip-flop was. And pretty much now, if you ignore everything to the left of where I'm looking right now, so all that redstone, just ignore it. From right here... this is all part of the T flip-flop, and it comes through here and all the way to here. So this is something I'm actually pretty proud of, because, you know, the only way you're going to get good at redstone is by learning about it and just implementing it and doing it yourself. So when I try to make these redstone stuff, I try to actually learn why it works, not how to do it, but why it works. And so I learned if I'm able to do a T flip-flop, then I can turn that pressure plate up there like a button, or I mean like a lever. And so whenever I press it, this piston will get powered and it'll come over here, and pretty much that's how it works with the lever, or with the pressure pad. Dang, I cannot get my words right. But I'm pretty stoked about it. The problem I'm having right now is figuring out how to close it up afterwards. So, but I'm not worried about that right now. Then what I started working on was my long piston elevator. I just started working on it. I thought I would let y'all guys get a look of it real quick. This is going to be about the space it will require for redstone going up. If we come over here, here is where one farm is, and unfortunately won't be centered because this is a 2 wide and I've been building in odds. So if I could redo it all now, I would have made each farm even and just have like no center point. But then the glowstone and stuff would have gotten messed up. So I don't know. Just something to think about if you're trying to replicate this. And yeah, I'm going to see what we can do with all this. I think I'm going to keep working on the piston elevator and see if I can't get it to work. It's going to take a while. But since it's the next day, I feel rejuvenated, and I feel like I can grind out on some work here. But, man, I'm loving how this is all coming together. And pretty much we're just going to have a big old little hub right down here in the middle to connect everything. And this thing will just kind of be in the center of it all. And hopefully this will work. If not, then it's going to be a pain to fix. But thought I would just let y'all guys see this real quick. And probably this next clip will be the end of the episode, so I'll catch up to you guys here again in a little bit. Sorry that I'm not building at all on camera today. Just a lot of little progress reports. Voila! What do you think, guys? I've done way, way more work on this. More than I was anticipating for this episode, but I did more for a reason, and I'll tell y'all why in a little bit. But let's focus on this for a minute. This is our little central hub. We're at the very bottom layer. We're at level 9. And we got the three areas. Uno, dos, tres. And we got the piston elevator. Now, good news and bad news. Bad news is this won't really work if iron golems are spawning. If any bit of lag happens, I end up getting stuck midway up. And then I have to dig out... and then fall on these ladders to get out of there. And so I have two ladders on each side, and right now I have this as the drop for the water, which doesn't really work. I almost died a second ago falling down it, but I'll figure out a better spot. I'm thinking about maybe putting a little spot right here that you can fall through and just have it all in this little area. I think that would be pretty cool. But let's give it a test. I don't know if any iron golems are up right now or not. So here we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, a little bit of lag. Oh, there's a second bit of lag. And we got it. And then I could just go like this. I fix this. Come on up. Walk over it. Pow. Oh, oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, I love it. Also, since we're going to be needing a lot of jack-o'-lanterns, I've been growing some pumpkins. We need a bunch. So, man. Oh, man, I love that. We'll give it another look here in a second. I just want to see if there's any iron golems here. Nope. Okay. But if there are some, it gets rough going up that piston elevator. And I'm sure we'll get stuck here in a minute. But it's good to see that that works out for the majority of it. I mean, that was so fast, how fast we're able to get down. Close that. Grass is still there. And I guess we'll try this again. No, we won't. Enderpearl down. I don't want to die right now. Not in the middle of recording. So, I have a color palette here. I'm trying to figure some stuff out, how I want to do the room. I've been wanting to implement quartz for the longest time. And I might do it, might not. Not sure. And yeah, this is really coming along. I like it a lot. You know, I'll have some walls to cover up all the redstone stuff. And we are going to have to figure how we're going to do all this. Oh, I love it. Here, let's give this another shot. I could have made this where I could go back down the piston elevator. But I was like, it's slower. And there's no need for it, in my opinion, if I can just drop down. All right, here we go. Let's look up this time. I think I looked up last time. Oh, this is smooth. Oh, there was a little bit of lag there, and a little bit more right there at the end. But man, I love how fast it goes. Oh, it's so much fun. I love it. Look, be forewarned, if you make this on a multiplayer server, that it's not going to work for other players. It's only going to work for the host for the most part. So be prepared for that. Feeling good, feeling good. Oh, see a little bit of lag right there in that one spot. Oh, this goes up 50 blocks, by the way. So that's pretty cool. I'm loving it. This is awesome. Really proud of everything. A lot of redstone this episode. And that's why I didn't show much for it. But some things I'm trying to consider now is working on a collection system. So the water is going to fall down right here, and I have these blocks, so then the water will hit and then it'll flow down here, and I might just have it all collect right here. I'll put some ice underneath it just to make it go a little bit faster, and we'll grab it there. And the second thing I was thinking about is in the future having storage minecarts go up to the surface. So I'm thinking about maybe fixing something up. I don't really think I need to work on it right now because I don't know where I'm going to have it all go. So, but let's talk about some good news here. Just released, Minecraft Xbox One will be out Friday. What does that mean for C-LuvGaming? Well, we're gonna make the switch, and I think we're gonna make the switch on Friday. Part of me doesn't want to, just to see if there's any bugs and stuff, and I know I can always just revert back and keep playing on the 360, but yeah, I'm just trying to figure everything out. A little bit nervous for it. It's gonna be awesome. The bigger world. Originally, I didn't want to move straight to the Xbox One until Mesa biomes were in the game. So then there would be a chance whenever we would create our world 36 times bigger that we'd have a Mesa biome. Because if I want hardened clay, a lot of it. And I don't know if the rivers and the lakes and stuff are going to give me enough of the quantity that I want of everything. But who knows when the mesa biomes are going to come in. And I guess we'll worry about that problem when it arises. Because, oh man, it's going to be fun having a 36 times bigger world. And I figured, you know, my next episode in this world will probably be in the Xbox One. I think my 400 subscriber special will be us going to the Xbox One and seeing everything that this beautiful world can offer us. And who knows? I think that episode we'll just go exploring a lot, and I might even live stream as well some of it. And see if we can't come up with some new areas for us to go build and establish stuff at. We know I had our adventure land not too far from here planned out, and I did a little building out there, but not enough to make me stay. Like, I can pack up and move and find a new place to do it. Oh, there's just gonna be so much stuff. We'll actually have a legit jungle somewhere. It's gonna be awesome. But one other thing I wanted to do real quick, I forgot to do this earlier, is give y'all the... Because last episode, some of you guys sent in some pictures and some of your own builds and stuff of what we've been doing. And it was great for inspiration, so I thought I would... since I'm going to be needing help with this little room, thought I'd give y'all the dimensions. And of course, we got pumpkin, water, all that stuff on this side. 1, 2, 3, 1, and then 7. This is a 7x7 where all the wheat is. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the pumpkins. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So hopefully that will be all the dimensions you need. And right here it is 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the 5th level is where the ceiling is. And then 6 right there. So... yeah, I decided to do a lot more work on the wheat farm and stuff off camera because of the Xbox One. You know, the next few episodes are going to be surrounded by that, hopefully. I hadn't even hooked up the Xbox One yet or anything like that. Had never logged in, signed in, any of that stuff. So I'm going to have to get all my recording stuff set up, make sure the settings are good, and we can get some good... footage for you guys. I gotta get ready. It's 2 days away, and then Destiny comes out on Tuesday, and I want to make content for that. So if you have any ideas how I should do the Destiny content, feel free to let me know what you guys would like to see, because it's gonna cut into a little bit of my Minecraft playing time, and Achilles will be playing it as well, so it's gonna be a blast. But I think we've covered everything now that I wanted to. Let's see, only one guy here. Let's do one more little test with the elevator. But it's working good for the most part. I just have to make sure if I ever go down there to clear out the iron. And we should be good. And there'll be other ways I can get up too. So it won't be that big of a deal if the elevator busts. Oh, I waited too long. Dang it. Forgot about that. That's okay. That'll happen from time to time. Let's go back down. Perfect. It's kind of dark in this spot. I'm kind of worried something's going to spawn here. Alright, so line up in the middle. Hit it. 360s all the way up. See if that works. Oh gosh, that is so weird looking. I love it. I love it. And I don't know if I ever showed y'all the redstone. Let's see, can I get right there? No, I'm not going to risk it. But, yeah. So guys, I hope you have enjoyed today's episode. I know I did a lot of off-camera stuff, but it's got to get back into the flow of things when I take a week and a half, 2 weeks off from making videos. Got to get warmed up again. So guys, I hope you have a beautiful, beautiful day. Deuces.